Welcome back to Creative Excuses, where today we are getting real creative with the Elder Scrolls Online. I'm going to showcase for you my reshade preset and tell you a little bit about what it does to make the game look so much better, yet still familiar. Let's jump into it. So what do I think is so great about my reshade? Why do I use it over any of the other excellent reshades that are out there? The main reason I use my own is that in real life, I'm a photographer. So I have my own editing preferences for photos and videos, and my own ideas of how lighting and contrast should work. And generally, I like a subtle touch. Most reshades out there are pretty dramatic and cinematically stylized, which I'm just not a huge fan of, even though I can recognize that they're good. I've tried a few, and they just changed things too much. So I made my own. The other big reason I use my own is I can use the super cool and really fun to tinker with Raytraced Global Illumination Shader from Marty McFly. The shader, as I have it set up, is super subtle, but quite performance intensive. It's worth it though, because it increases contrast and saturation in the game in a way that looks really natural and pleasing to me. The global illumination and ambient occlusion provided by the shader also looks significantly better than the screen space GI provided by the developers in the game engine. Take a look at the difference here. You can see in the game's screen space GI implementation that around characters' legs especially, there are significant shadows that don't look natural. It's like characters are wearing skirts made of shadow. Once you see it, you can't unsee it. So for me, that makes this setting completely unusable. It looks like garbage to me, which is a real shame because I think the intent of it is to look like this RT shader does, but with better performance. But it just doesn't. So adding ray tracing to my game is one of the big changes. But the other major change my reshade makes is to color. The changes to color are not super significant, but I do think they make the game much more pleasing to look at. Essentially, I've slightly brightened the game by altering the white point, while increasing contrast a little by increasing the black point. I also changed some color gamma settings and added a very slight tint to replace the generally green hue of the vanilla lighting with a more pleasing and fantastical pink tone. Last, I use a very good, very subtle sharpening filter adapted from some AMD tech that is subtle, but makes the game look ever so slightly more in focus than vanilla without the gross over sharpening effect that I see way too often. The end product is subtle and pleasing, I think. If you want to download my reshade settings, head to my Discord linked in the description. There's a channel there with installation instructions, any file downloads, and a link where you can get both the ray tracing and regrade shaders that I use in my main file. So enjoy the rest of these comparisons between vanilla and my reshaded ESO, and I will see you all in the next excuse.